were very interested in understanding the structure of the nucleus, this mothership for the genome, and how it helps each type of cell in our body do the right thing and respond the right way to all the signals our body cells are giving each other constantly. I came from a lab that was doing molecular genetics, and I realized that people could now crush frog eggs and build the nucleus of a cell in a test tube. And you just had to give it some DNA to start with, some chromosomes. You chuck them in there and watch them. And at first it's just DNA, but very rapidly a wall is built around it, a wall made of a membrane, and it's actually a double membrane. So, and it starts building holes, very important holes that move things in and out, let things move in and out, called nuclear pore complexes. But meanwhile, the chromosomes, they're not lumps anymore, they're becoming spread out. And inside, in the middle of this, not shown, is where all the chromosomes are. But now, it's a working nucleus of the cell, and you can't really see individual chromosomes anymore. They're all spread out and puffy, and they're doing their jobs. They're expressing genes, and but we began to appreciate how beautiful and complex the structure of this nucleus was. There's the possibility that we can start actually connecting the dots to understand how specific diseases are caused by specific changes. Maybe there's a way I can help that interaction or block it to help people with very specific and sometimes devastating diseases. And some of this work actually is so relevant to normal human aging that it might help us live longer and be more healthy as we grow older. Nobody minds being older. They just don't want to feel it.